Back in the mid-1970s, there was a thought that the Bonneville cutthroat trout might have even been extirpated. But as state agencies and others looked for this fish, we found that there were still quite a few populations around. We've been working really hard on this fish for the last 20 to 30 years, and now we have really good populations, and actually it has been petitioned twice to be federally listed as threatened, but with the conservation actions that we've undertaken, demonstrate that it doesn't warrant that protection.
I mean, words can't even express how excited I am about this project. I mean, just to see the BLM involved with so many great partners. We're a lot of the time not known for cold water fisheries like this. We have a lot of desert fish habitat.
And cutthroat trout, who spawn in the spring, don't overpopulate, and we should be seeing in probably 3 years some fish that are at least 12 inches in this stream. These fish went to our hatchery in Logan, the fisheries experiment station, and they were able to raise 5,600 fish that we stocked into Randolph Creek today. Very exciting. Fruition of a project that we've been working on for probably 8 or 9 years. So 5,600 fish in 7 miles of stream gives us about 800 fish per mile, which is a really good number of fish to be stocking back into the stream. We've got a great source of fish to establish a population here.
To me, the Bonneville cutthroat trout with the black spots and the light background are just a beautiful fish. The fish are 100% Bonneville cutthroat trout, genetically pure.
In the end, we're gonna be, you know, restoring native fish to over 50 miles of habitat, and 50% of that is on BLM lands. And just to see that come to fruition and to work with partners to do it with great people and great partnerships just puts a smile on my face.
The partnerships we've developed here between the Division of Wildlife, the Bureau of Land Management, Trout Unlimited, and the landowners are just getting stronger every year, and these fish will be here for generations to come.
I think we're going to see a lot of support for this project from the public overall, especially once they're at a catchable size for fishing, which is pretty exciting. We want future generations to enjoy these fish and catch these native fish and to get out on public lands and appreciate them and use them.
And projects like these are just additional ones that will help this fish into the future maintain a good part of its habitat.
We are getting to develop a program for BLM fisheries, and there's just a lot of really great opportunities for that are very exciting. Awesome.